Welcome to Learn Commerce PU online classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students, welcome to History online class. In the last class, we have discussed about the Egyptian civilization, the beginning, how Egyptian civilization emerged. And today's class, we have to discuss the contribution made by Egyptians. What are all the contributions they have made? And the first one, the political contribution, political condition. How polity was established? Egyptian civilization, which was village in nature, or whole Egypt, you know, included the village. And gradually, there arose kingship. King came to existence. But this king, he ruled a particular area. There were many kings in Egypt. Gradually, these kings began to quarrel themselves. And ultimately, they established kingdom. Kingdom. But before this, only kings that we call pre-kingdom, pre-dynastic period, there was no dynasty. But in the later period, they established dynasty or kingdom, even came to power. And this kingdom, many rulers, they ruled Egypt in the different times. And nearly 30 dynasties, they ruled Egypt, and for nearly 3,000 years. So this is what a great dynastical rule for 3,000 years. And what we can see, no dynasty ruled more than 6 or 7 generations. Well, and king of Egypt is called Pharaoh. They are called Pharaohs. The king is called Pharaoh. Well, they considered, this king is considered is the most powerful one, and he is considered the representative of God on the earth. Is a representative of God on the earth. Andre, Devara oba pratinidhiyagi ee bhoomiyalli idaneva. ಅವ ಆಳ್ತಾನೆ, ಜನರನ್ನು ಆಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಜನರಿಗೆ ದೇವರ ಬದಲು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಜನೇ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ. ರಾಜ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಕ್ಷ ದೇವತಾ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದು ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲ್ಪನೆ ಇದೆ. ಹಾಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಫೆರೋವಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ವೆಲ್, ದೆನ್ ದೇ ದೀಸ್ ಫೆರೋವಾಸ್ ದೇ ಯುನೈಟೆಡ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೌತ್ Egypt, somewhere around 3000 BCE. Idi yedu bhala dodda Egyptian kandavanna, aa Egyptian deshavanna sumaru 3000 varshagala Krista purva illi adanna north mattu south idanna oggudistare. Yake anta igagle nanu helide, adu tundu 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 tundagi bere bere rajyargalu adanna aalta idru. ಈಗ ಅದನ್ನು ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಸೇರಿಸುವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗಾರ್ಮೆಂಟ್, of Egyptian kings. It was absolute, nirankusha. Antakarte, absolute. And they were centralized, more centralized and absolute power, central government. So this is what we can see, the political aspect was very systematically established. And the periods here, we can divide the period of old kingdom, period of old kingdom and period of middle kingdom and period of new kingdom. In these three categories, we can divide the political system of Egypt. Period of old kingdom, that is the old system, old kingship, and later middle kingdom, and lastly new kingdom. In these three phases, the political system continued. And Amenhotep first, he belonged to middle kingdom and he is one of the greatest king of Egypt. And one more king, that is Thutmose, Thutmose, Thutmose. This Thutmose is also one of the important kings, and he conquered new territory and added to Egyptian kingdom. So his contribution, that is extension of empire, Egyptian empire. And then his daughter Hatshepsut. She is the first women king, I mean empress of the world. You know, Hatshepsut is the daughter of Thutmose, and she is the first empress of the world. That's very important. Who is the first empress of the world? She is the first empress of the world, and she ruled nearly 20 years. So this is the political condition and achievements of Egyptian kings and their political condition. When we come to social condition, how society was existed, and society of Egypt divided into three categories, three class, that is upper class, middle class, and slaves. So Egyptian society was divided into three categories or three classes, that is upper class, middle class, and slaves. Upper class, which consisted of royal family, priest, royal family, priests, military officers, and nobles, So this is the category which belong to various other, you know, professions and, you know, category. And middle class, which consisted of physician, scribes, craftsmen, etc. And then the third category is the lower category, that is the slaves. They are the lower category and they were exploited class. Exploited class. They were the lowermost strata of the society. So in this way, this society was divided. And then, what is the status of women? In different society, the status of women is also different. Here, when we see, you know, Hatshepsut, she became empress. It shows that women had very good position under Egyptian civilization. Or Egyptian civilization or society gave importance to women. Their position was high. Women's position was high. They enjoyed high status and equal share. Equal share in the ancestral property. Hiriyara aastiyalli gandu makkalage ivarigu kuda share sikta itu. Equal share. And then especially pharaohs married their own daughter or sisters. Daughters and sisters. Why? This is a strange system you may find. Magalanna mattu sahodariyaranna rajarugalu madve aagta iddaru. Karana enu? Because even these women also had equal shares in their property. If so, if they arrange in marriage with other people, this share will be gone to some other people. That's why they wanted to keep their kingdom or share a property with them, so that they used to marry their daughters or at the same time their sisters. This is one. Second reason for marrying them is the keeping purity of blood. Their purity of blood. If they, you know, arrange marriage with the others, their blood will mix. So their purity will go. That's why for this reason they used to marry their daughter and sisters. So this is what a very important thing in their social aspect. This is about society. Society division and their system. And then economy, third one. Economy. How? Economy, basically Egyptian society was an agrarian society. Agriculture was the main occupation. That is everywhere what we can see, agriculture. Apart from this, how they, you know, did agriculture? Irrigation. There was irrigation facility. How? You know, Egypt is the gift of Nile. That's why this Nile River is a source of irrigation for their agriculture. And they cultivated cotton, barley, garlic, fruits and vegetable. The main crop, cotton, barley, garlic, fruits and vegetable are the main crops cultivated by Egyptian. And they used sadus. Sadu for irrigation. For the irrigation purpose. Niravarige bekagi. Sadoof galu. Andre eta anta karitave. Ige ettidaga neeranna cheluvantadu. Aa mulakavagi avaru aa sadoof galanna upayoga martta idru anadannu nortave. So this is the economic system of, you know, Egyptian people. Well, what about the religion? Religious condition. They had different gods, or what we call the polytheism. Variety of gods, variety of gods or polytheism. Polytheism means more than one god. What we call for one god, that is monotheism, that is Christianity or Islam. They have one god, monotheism. Hinduism, polytheism, many gods. Likewise, Egyptians also had different gods, what we call the polytheism, many gods. And animism, polytheism, animism. What is meant by animism? Means worshipping of animals. Even in India, we worship cow. We worship cow. So this is what a polytheism has it. Animism means worshipping of animals. Worshipping of animals. And another one, totemism means worshipping of tree. They used to worship tree, because in India we used to worship different trees, people tree, isn't it? So likewise, even Egyptian, they used to worship trees, what we call totemism. And Amun Ra, their gods, we have Vishnu, Shiva, Ganapati, and different gods we have. And Indra is a god. And here, Amun Ra, Amun Ra is the god of gods, is the king of gods. Is the king of gods, like Indra is the king of God. The Amun Ra is the king of gods. And Amun Ra believed to be the creator of Egypt. Egyptanna nirmana madidanta obba devaru andre Amun Ra anta avaru namutare. Amale ulada devarugalu, Ra means sun god, Surya Devaru, Osiris, God of Dead. Now Yama, Savina Devaru. Here Osiris is a god of dead, and Isis, she is the mother god, Thai Devate, mother god and wife of Osiris, Osiris. Apart from these gods, there are Horus, Hathor, etc. So these are all the gods they used to worship. Different gods, and they had different temples also. What we call different temples for these gods, because these Egyptians, they are the great builders, and they had different temples they built for the god. And they believed in the transmigration of soul. What is transmigration of soul? If a person died, his soul will not die, but it will migrate and lead to another birth, or it will merge with a newborn one. This is a transmigration of soul. And those who do good, and they will be getting good life, or what they believe, there is life after death, and our soul after our death will go and involve in a body, and that will be good if you do good. If you are not good, then your soul will emerge with the least animals. So this is the belief of Egyptian, and they also worshipped their ancestors. Especially they did mummification. What is meant by mummification? So after the death, body will be kept as it is in a coffin box, and they will apply different chemicals, and they kept in the coffin. And that is what we call mummification. And most of the kings' dead body are still kept in the pyramids. The pyramids are the tombs of kings. So mummification. So this is very important aspects of Egyptian civilization so far as religion is concerned. And let us go to their literature, literary work. As you know, these Egyptians, they developed a special script, or what we call pictography. Pictography. What is meant by pictography? Pictography is a writing with a picture. For example, this is the picture of fish. This having one particular meaning. Pictograph, pictures. Through pictures, every picture has one letter or one word. And Egyptian, this pictography, a particular letter depicts maybe one letter or one word, and it sounds differently. That is called pictography. And they used to write in the papyrus like a leaf, and it's also called their writing is called hieroglyphics. We call hieroglyphics. The writing is called hieroglyphics. So this is very important thing. And they had different books that also contributed. The great works are some important works I can write. That is the Book of Dead. The Book of Dead. Another one, Coffin Test. Coffin Text. And third one, Story of Shipwrecked Sailor. And fourthly, the tale to Anoop and Bittu. Anoop and Bittu. So these are all the works available so far as their literature is concerned. And they had the knowledge of even mathematics, medicine, logic. Apart from this, this Egyptian also had the knowledge of medicine. Knowledge of medicine, astronomy, astrology, mathematics, etc. So in the beginning, even 5,000 years ago, they had such a knowledge of all these things. That's very important to note. And they prepared one calendar. We have calendar of 365 days calendar per year, isn't it? So the same manner, these Egyptian, they developed one calendar which consisted 365 days per year. And it is divided into 12 months of 30 days. 12 months of 30 days. So this is how they used to calculate. And even today we have 30 days, 12 months per year. So this is another important contribution of an Egyptian. Then you should see they had clock, shadow clock. Shadow clock. Neralina moolaka samayavanna nirdharisuvanta. Adanna shadow clock anta kelthare. Udaharanege ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಶ್ಯಾಡೋ ಕ್ಲಾಕ್ ಇತ್ತು. ಸೂರ್ಯ ಹುಟ್ಟುವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟಿಪ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ, ಆ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರುವಾಗ ಕಿರಣಗಳು ಈ ತರ ಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಬೈ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ shadow clock. Shadow clock. They had such knowledge. This is their a greater contribution. And they used to send their children to get education at the age of 5. ಐದು ವರ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಎಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಗುರುವಿನಲ್ಲಿಗೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ 12 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 12 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದೆಮ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ನೋಟ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ such a knowledge of these things, and education and even literature, especially the science and technology, they had different knowledge. This is the greater contribution. And their trade and commerce, when you come to the trade and commerce, it's very important to know they had internal and external trade. Antarika mattu antarashtriya. Antarika andre deshada olagade, internal trade. And international, out of the country, they had trade relation with the Mediterranean Sea, Asian part. And this is what, during that time only, the international trade, not only in their own land but even out of the country, they had the trade relations. And they had different types of craftsmen, that is carpenters, stone cutters, potters, jewelry makers, etc. Even this is their craftsmanship, skills. Trade and commerce, what we can see, they used copper in the beginning. Later they used bronze, brass, gold and iron. Different metals were also used by them. In this way, they had even the knowledge of metallurgy. They used metals, not only stones. Well, now we have to come to another important contribution of Egyptian civilization, that is architecture, art and architectures. The Egyptians were the great pattern of art and architecture. They built many temples. They built many pyramids. That's why we call, that is the land of pyramid or country of pyramid. It is only in Egypt you can find the beautiful what you call pyramids. Pyramid structure, you know, in the triangle shape. So that is very calculation of this pyramid, how they have to build. The mathematical calculation they used to build this what you call buildings or pyramids. They were the great builders. They built temples, pyramids, and they used sandstone. Limestone, wood and granite. So for the purpose of building, they use different materials. That is sandstone, now muragallu anta karithavilli, and limestone, wood and granite. These materials were used for the construction of building by the Egyptian. And Spanish This is one of the pyramids, and this pyramid, or what we call Sphinx, had a head of man and body of lion. Manushana tale adra deha simhad idannu gamanisirabodu chitragalalli bahala sundaravadanta ondu pyramid idu adakke Sphinx anta karitave naavu. ಇದು ಯಾರು ತಯಾರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಂಪರರ್ ಕಾಫ್ರೆ. ಕಾಫ್ರೆ ಎಂಪರರ್ ಕಾಫ್ರೆ ಹೀ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಸ್ಫಿನಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಿರಮಿಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ 240 ಫೀಟ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ and 66 feet height. The big pyramid Sphinx and 240 feet length and 66 feet height. So this covered very nearly, you know, a large area was covered, and even covered out of, you know, this particular Sphinx, this is carved out of single stone, monolithic anta karitheva antu, monolithic stone, onde kallinalli kettal pattanta ee Sphinx idrinda kettal padutide. And another important what you call pyramid, that is Giza. Giza pyramid. This is one of the wonders of the world and biggest pyramid of the world. Giza pyramid is the biggest pyramid and one of the wonders of the world. And what is the area covered by this pyramid? Nearly 746 into 746 into 481 height. Andre, idu 746, idu 746, innondu badi kuda adhe riti irutade. And this pyramid, what is the height? 481 feet height, 746 here, 746 here, and other part also. And this way, this very systematically constructed by using mathematical calculation. ಗಣಿತದ ಲೆಕ್ಕಾಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟಲ್ಪಡುತ್ತೆ ಬಹಳ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರ್ಡ್ ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ 13 acres ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. 13 acres ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಪಿರಮಿಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್, ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟೋನ್, what is the weight? 2.5 ton, 2,500 kilo ondondu kallugalu. How they used to construct, and they have taken this, you know, very very huge stones to the height of that particular pyramid. That's a great technology used by them during the very ancient period. We have to appreciate them for the technology used for the construction of that pyramid. And nearly 23 lakhs stones were used for the construction, and they have taken 20 years to complete. 20 years to complete such a big, what you call, pyramid they constructed. And very important, no? The very big construction made by them. And then even one more temple, Luxor, it is also their contribution, and it was provided with the roads and even the gates, and it's a one more temple of Egyptian. So this is what Egyptian contribution. Then even though they had all these glorious days, gradually this civilization declined. Why this civilization declined? What are the reason for the downfall of civilization? What we can see? Now every civilization emerges, reaches its peak, and once again downfall. Likewise, even Egyptian civilization also ultimately disappeared. And there are many causes for the decline of Egyptian civilization. What we can see, some of the important factors: disunity. Invasion. Failure of rulers. Internal quarrels. Internal quarrels. So because of the disunity, no, there was no unity in the later period. Or even the rulers also failed to maintain unity. When there is no unity, automatically a country led to the invasion of outsiders. That's why, because of the invasion of other countries, this is another reason. When there was no unity among them, even India in the beginning invaded by Arabs, British, French, Dutch. Why? Because of the disunity among Indian rulers. Likewise, since there was no unity or disunity among the rulers, that led to the invasion of other force, external force. And one more thing, failure of rulers, weak rulers. In order to continue a particular civilization, ruler should be very strong. Here in Egypt, as time passes, they became weak and they could not continue this civilization. They could not continue rule, and that's also another reason for the failure. And internal quarrels. There was internal quarrels among themselves, among the rulers. When there was an internal quarrel, automatically a system fails. Here in Egypt also, because of the internal quarrel, they failed and ultimately they disappeared. This civilization disappeared. And one more thing, exploitation. exploitation. Exploitation or ruthless exploitation. This is one more cause for decline of Egyptian civilization. So in this way, ultimately, what we can see, this great civilization disappeared. But the remains, that glory of olden days, still remaining as a showcase to the world, their contributional showcase or showcase of their achievements, it still remained. So this is what the contribution of Egyptian civilization and their downfall. So thank you very much.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.